really was such a reward as a dancer to learn some of the most classic choreography ever made.
But to be on this job, you had to be a dancer. And I don't mean somebody who just does one style. I mean being a dancer, being able to do everything.
That 6-day-a-week schedule with this kind of choreography, this intense, it was hard.
The specific details of the movement are so specific to him and the way that he moves that you're like, oh, I did not know what I was doing at all, actually.
The choreography is perfect. It was just so incredible to be a part of that legacy.
As much as I was here for the man, I was also realizing the opportunity of working with some of the best dancers in the world as well.
The classic choreography that he did all those years in the videos, on the tour, I think it's just a really big blessing to do that.
I remember waking up every day and being so ecstatic to go to work.
The job was just a dream. It was constant fun, magic, love. What else can you ask for?
God bless you.
All of the dancers were new to Michael. We had 9 guys and 2 girls, and I had worked with Michael before as a dancer, and it was very special to me. But to see it from dancers really of another generation be that excited, it was crazy.
It was funny to see the dancers on the first day. I think Michael was always mischievous and loved surprises, so we just sort of walked in on them, and they didn't know he was going to be there. And they all were just so startled, they froze. I think some started crying, and it was just great, you know, and he just got such a kick out of it, and he giggled and giggled and hugged them all and thanked them for being here and told them, you know, he said, it goes both ways, you know, I can't take credit for any of this, you know, thank you for being here with me. You know, and I think that comforted them. Understandably, your first rehearsal with Michael Jackson is going to be just an experience you're not prepared for. You can't prepare for that. You know, I remember as a dancer when we first started working together, I told him, I was like, excuse me if I stare at you. Sorry, I don't mean anything by it. I'm just having a process. I'm coming to terms with what I'm doing and what this all means. So if I'm just sort of staring at you blankly, you know, don't take offense. He's like, it's okay, I understand, it's okay.
Woo! Keep going.
Michael would ask me all the time, he goes, are they the right ones? And I'd say, yep. You know, they love to dance. I was like, yep. He was like, do they get along? I was like, yep. He was like, how do the girls act with each other? They love each other. They have lunch together every day. Oh, good. You know, so he was very in tune to, you know, some things that could go wrong that affect the show. So it was impossible to have anybody that was going to not contribute to this experience.
That could happen there.
Well, on the round.
Yeah.
I'll never forget just getting ready to pick dancers, and Michael said, I don't want any fake flowers without the fragrance, which means it's deeper and it's further beyond the aesthetic. It's like people that dance from their soul, people that create and live artistically from their bones. And those are the people that came onto this project.
Does he leave it?
Yeah, leave it.
Okay.
We had the best dancers on this tour. I love, and I mean, I love their guts. They were the best dancers, the most talented dancers, the best people to work with ever.
Chris Grant. I see a lot of myself in Chris being, you know, roughly the same age as he is now when I started dancing with Michael. I just responded to him right away. And in fact, I think he was the first dancer that Michael selected. He said, look at that joker go. You know, and he pointed at him. He was like, yes, yes, yes.
Chris Grant stepped forward.
I don't know what I'm feeling right now, actually. It's like a dream. I still can't believe it. I can't believe he's here. And I just felt his presence even before they said he was here. So it was just, I can't believe it. Like, I can't even talk.
He was just so emotional when we told him. You know, I almost was like, is he going to be able to handle it? Because he's so sensitive and fragile. But then when he gets on stage, he's a beast. And I get that. And I think Michael responded to that, too, because he possessed those very same qualities. Chucky is just wonderful and brought a certain thing to the table that was undeniable.
I remember specifically Michael picking him out right away. And Chucky, ironically enough, is one of the smallest dancers. He's a little guy, but when he dances, he's bigger than everybody.
I'm 5'5". The audition on the sheet, it said you have to be 5'8 and above, and I'm like, should I even go? What do I do? And I said to myself, I'm gonna put on the tallest shoes I can, no matter how heavy they are, I'm gonna figure it out. Because I'm supposed to dance for Michael Jackson. I'm supposed to. I have to.
Chucky is also an amazing Michael fan, and his knowledge of Michael over the years, I think, really, really helped him to shine.
I'm a big fan of Michael Jackson. I grew up learning every move I could possibly learn on television. They used to call me Chucky Encyclopedia in rehearsal, kind of making fun of me, kind of not, kind of real, because I knew every single step, but I was so adamant about doing it correctly, so we learned one little thing wrong. Stacy will tell you, like, I'd be like, I think Michael did it on this foot, and she'd be like, let's look at the video, and I'd be right, because I remember so many little details. And so in rehearsal, every number we learned, I was like, I can't believe we're actually learning this. And the whole time we were doing it, I think everyone appreciated that. All the dancers appreciated what it is that we were a part of. No one took it for granted. We were all so lucky to be a part of this project and to be a part of this chapter in Michael's history.
Daniel, who's from Canada, is more of a street dancer, very masculine and very identifiable with, I think, sort of the younger kids who are into breakdancing and crumping and all of this sort of newer stuff.
I always trained classically and everything, and I was always considered a kind of like the funky kid because I just love to, you know, dance on the side and do, you know, I guess weird stuff. So when I saw the style Electric Boogaloo, I was like, wow. It was a style that Michael Jackson actually learned at a very young age. Then it came from Soul Train, and it was all about soul music. So it was pure, like, spirit, like it came from the soul. And it was true dancing. I knew, you know, this is what I wanted to do, and this was for me. And I got to a point where Electric Boogaloo was my lifestyle now. It was more than just an art to practice. And I felt like I was compromising my life by conforming to what the people that hired me wanted to see. And so it came to the point where for 2 years, I stopped dancing professionally, and I worked with my dad at his deli. But I always said that the only artist I would really, you know, dance for would be Michael. Because Michael Jackson had the ability to stay true to the art forms he was practicing, whether it was dance, music, singing. So I was in the deli, and I got a phone call from my agent, and he said, I know you've been turning me down for the past couple of years to do gigs, but at the moment, I just received word that Michael Jackson's having an audition.
When we saw Daniel dance, we responded to his own original style, which is really, really cool. Then you have Devin, who is clearly technical, but just very quiet, you know, and he reminds me of a quiet storm.
The audition set the bar for the entire job. I kept thinking to myself, this is straight out of a Chorus line. Like, it was just that, God, I hope I get it kind of idea. Like, you're standing in a line on this stage, just completely vulnerable in the middle of this auditorium, and you just hear Kenny Ortega's voice on the microphone just echoing, like, praying that, you know, he calls your name.
Devin Jameson. Congratulations.
And I knew I was just an emotional mess.
Devin is also a wonderful actor, and he has theater in his movement, and you feel that he's dancing.
Michael was involved in every aspect of it. He would have notes for us as dancers, he would have notes for us as performers. He would have notes for us on our improvs, like freestyles, on our own moments that we had. And it would just be so much fun to take a note from Michael Jackson. Like, it was like, okay, wow.
Yay!
There's Nick Bass, who is definitely one of the seasoned professionals. He's worked with almost everybody.
This dude right here used to teach me. That's where I learned my stuff from.
I've taken from him too. Everyone's taken from
this. That's where I learned my stuff from.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
It's my brother right here.
But he was very humbled, you know, at the chance to work with Michael.
Nick Bass. Congratulations.
How you feeling, man?
Man, I don't know what I'm feeling. I'm just blessed to be where I'm at, you know. Happy for the guys that are doing it. This man, come all the way from Canada. Some of these guys I grew up dancing with.
You could see his professionalism have to even sort of take on a new spin because, you know, he's in front of his idol.
Nick said, what's after Michael? I never thought that far. You know, Michael was like the pinnacle, the goal.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me the chance. It's an honor to get to dance for the man.
So my name is Timur Steffens. I'm from Holland.
Timur only been dancing about 3 years. So he's really a success story. He's one of the newer, greener dancers that we had, but you could see in him every day that it was necessary for him to rise to the occasion. So he covered a lot of ground really fast.
When I came to this rehearsal and started to see the way Michael danced in real life, I started to doubt myself, like, what I was doing is actually not dancing. I tried to understand, like, why is dancing, you know what I mean? Because dancers that do only, for example, only body movements and isolations and everything, what is beautiful, but it's not really dancing anymore. It's isolating movements on rhythm. And dancing is getting lost because dancing is a feeling that you have. And when I started to rehearse with Michael Jackson, if you look closely what Michael Jackson is really doing and you listen to the music, he is an instrument of music. And if you were deaf, you could not hear music, and you look at him, you will see the music play in his body. And that just changed my whole view of dance, changed my whole point of view on life. Like, I don't know, I learned so much. Like, I just was like reborn in dance again.
We have Makia. Michael hand selected her.
I first heard about the audition. I debated even going because I thought for sure I would never be picked to be a Michael Jackson dancer. It just proves never doubt yourself.
We had seen every available female dancer possible. And, you know, Kenny and I had our own sort of favorites before Michael said, no, it's something about her. You know, she's a diamond in the rough. Look at her again. And then I slept on it, woke up, reviewed the tape again. I was like, he's right.
Amazing, ladies.
Michael was not in the audience, and I could see him really sort of being hands-on with the whole thing. And I'm so happy that he picked the people that he did because the group was so amazing together. We had such a fun time. There wasn't, you know how in every group there's sort of that one person that's like, mm. There wasn't the one. And I feel like there was something that Michael saw in each person that he picked because everyone was just so loving and so grateful and thankful to be there. And I think that he was able to see that that was part of his process of picking the dancers.
Tyne is absolutely amazingly technical dancer. You know, she's a ballerina.
I started dancing when I was 3 years old. My mom's a dance teacher, and she was one of my dance teachers growing up. So it's something that I've been doing since I was a little kid, and I knew probably when I was about 12 that this is what I wanted to try to pursue as a career.
She is the all-American, you know, sort of beauty, and she's sexy. But beyond that, she's a really wonderful person.
Thank you. It was really fun for Makia and I because it was just the two of us girls, and so we just got to be the sexy girls, and we kind of had a lot of room for creative freedom to just, you know, try different things and see what worked for us. But at the same time, things were so specific.
She grasped the styles very good, and we knew that, you know, little girls would like to look up to both Makia and Tyne, you know, because of their qualities. And very classy and beautiful. There was a grace to them both that is rare. Trace is someone who I've known for years and worked with before. And he had a wonderful story how, you know, Michael affected his life.
When I was growing up, we grew up on welfare. My mom pretty much was on welfare, actually for a good amount of time to keep me in dance, basically to keep me out of trouble.
He and his mom used to live in different places, you know. They didn't always have what they needed. He told me he'd slept in a park before. He had slept in his car before.
When I talked to Mike for the first time, I just passed him in the hallway and he saw me. He came up to me and he said, you know, I'm so happy for you and I'm so proud of you for your, you know, endurance through this struggle. You know what I mean? The fact that you were able to go from welfare to living in the park to dancing for me and dancing in this type of a show and dancing in this industry, period, still, when I should have left for home probably a long time ago, he really admired that. And I just wanted to thank him for that. That was a more than a motivation for me. That's going to keep me going no matter what happens after this.
You know, to see someone like that, who's that good, you know, finally be rewarded for all of the hard work is just heartwarming. And he's an awesome dancer.
My name is Shannon Holtzapfel. I was born in Holland. My parents were very heavily into the music scene and, you know, they were keeping it funky. And as soon as I could walk, my parents said I attempted the moonwalk. You know, I actually remember vivid images of watching Michael Jackson, Thriller, Billie Jean, you know. And then I moved to Australia when I was four and then they put me in a dance class. And ever since then, Michael Jackson's only ever been my inspiration and my dream, and he was my influence. I danced because of him.
Shannon Holtzapfel.
One of the guys we found from the furthest away is Shannon, and he just found out about the audition online, jumped on the next plane he could get on, and was in LA auditioning 2 days later.
It was an opportunity that I felt like I'd been training 20 years for, copying his moves, being inspired by his moves, just wanting to be there beside him, and now I had the chance. Not a lot of people in the world, you know, they get to chase their dreams, but I really had the opportunity at grasping my dreams.
When we saw him dance, it was just so much more thrilling because, you know, again, another person who was willing to do whatever it took. We're so thrilled to have found him. Not only is he really aesthetically handsome, but he's a fantastic performer. And he's just really a great guy. You know, he's a dude.
I'm Misha Gabriel, and my story about how I heard about the audition is kind of funny. I was on Facebook and I saw a video that a buddy of mine, Tony Testa, had posted. And in the video, he says, I'm canceling my trip because I have some certain projects I'm working on. And I was like, certain projects. Talked to a couple mutual friends, ended up hearing that Tony was involved in the Michael Jackson project, which, you know, so proud of him and so happy for him. But more than anything, I was like, wait, there's a Michael Jackson project, you know? So I called my agency and I harassed him. I was like, why haven't I been told about this audition? You know, where's this Michael Jackson audition happening? Even if I'm not called, I'm going. You have to tell me where it is. I'm going to crash this audition if I have to, because what this job represented for me was what I'd been working towards my whole life.
Misha is young and inspired and there and so present, you know, and so wonderful to be around because he just loves it. He loves it all. He wants to put on the shoes. He wants to get into the costumes. He never wants to take a break. He wants to do this. He wants to jump off of that.
There's no better feeling than dancing behind Michael. There really isn't. You know, I'm a dancer. This is what I do every day, all day. It's what I eat, breathe, and sleep. I've never felt like I danced as good as I did from dancing behind Michael. And it wasn't because I was afraid, you know, that I need to dance better to keep up. It's the energy that you get from him.
Being surrounded by Misha's energy is infectious, you know, and it keeps you really, you know, sort of aware of how fortunate we all are, you know, when you see them as happy as they were.
Even someone did a heel.
It was the most beautiful, pure job I've ever worked on in my life.
God bless you.
And the last line is three.
And when you jump out, the last line is four.
Five, six, seven, eight, you go one.
In order to train the dancers, what we did was we spit out as much choreography as quickly as we could because this style is so particular and intricate that it takes a while to sink into your body.
We started to learn the classics, you know, Dangerous, Smooth Criminal, and Jam, and Thriller. The scheduling was that we get the classics back on their feet first.
Should I be like this?
And it was so great to see everyone's sort of own interpretation of it, and the younger ones, bless their hearts, they knew it on the opposite side.
Keep it like that.
From having learned it off TV. So I got a kick out of that. I thought that was awesome.
I know it's weird. You guys should go this way.
I know for me, teaching Jam was a nightmare.
I ain't too much for me.
And it's one of my favorite numbers to see because it's such high energy, but it's such a brain teaser.
I
I wasn't expecting that one to be as difficult as it was, but that one was the hardest for me to catch on to, just a different accent. But it was the funnest one to do after I got it.
I told the dancers in rehearsal, I said, you guys better learn this now, like the back of your hand, because when Michael gets up there and starts dancing with you, you're gonna freak out. You're gonna forget everything. Trust me. Mm-hmm. They did.
When we got on stage, when Michael rose up on the elevators, and you just saw the first time they all just sort of looked at him and became audience members when they're on stage, supposed to be performing with him. But that's the effect he had on people. And it never went away, it never changed. You know, every time he walked into a room, everything would stop. You know, he tried to be cool, you know, and keep playing the song, but you're definitely checking out what he's checking out.
In those first days where he was on stage with them, I would love it. And I would go up to a dancer or you know, afterwards and go, I saw when Michael turned and looked at you that you almost fell off of your feet. And I would giggle because, you know, it was like, you know, almost too much.
The first few times were a little hairy, I think, for them. But then they settled into it and they were on it and delivered fully and completely.
Full of heart, full of heart.
And Michael loved having them behind him, you know? He could really feel their energy and play off their energy.
It's so awesome.
One day he came on stage and started dancing, so I looked at him and I was like, and he looked at me and he was like, bow, and he started doing like, and I was like, next thing I know, Mike looks at me, like going like this, like smiling, like, went up to him, you know, shook his hand, gave him a hug, and I'm like, did I just exchange with the man? Like, whoa, like, this is heavy, like, this is something else.
It's funny, when you see him standing out on the stage and his dancers are behind him, he kind of makes his dancers look like they're taking a clinic, and he's the master teacher, because his moves are so on point, so exacting, and so specialized, it's hard for anybody else to measure up to his expertise and his level of perfection. It's really amazing and inspiring to work with him, to watch him work, and to be a part of the whole process.
Great collaboration between Michael and the dancers, for sure.
He inspired every single one of them to dance. I mean, it was a great part of the joy of being, you know, the director of the show. I got to be up front watching all of that magic happening between them.
Just keeps getting better every day. Like before, it was amazing feeling to have gotten it, and then changed to like, okay, now I'm ready to do this now, I'm ready to go.
The excitement of getting it and then starting to work, and the boot camp of rehearsals being like super hard and strenuous, and then all of a sudden you get used to that workout. It just starts to feel good, and the pacing, you know, stamina, everything's starting to come together.
We have the luxury of taking our time and doing it right, because we also have to protect the bodies. If people are too burnt out, there's more injuries. So Michael purposely wanted to give the dancers an opportunity in those first couple of weeks to get on their feet, as he says, to feel comfortable and confident, so that then you're not obsessing about the moves. You know them and you feel them and they're a part of you. So it doesn't matter what happens, because in a show you never know. You've got all of this amazing technical stuff to deal with. You have pyro bombs going off beside you. You're wearing these heavy costumes. You're strapped in to machines and things that lift you in the air, and it becomes where, you know, you can't be thinking about the choreography and you can't be thinking about the steps, you know, because now you've got to navigate the show. And it was wonderful getting them to that point.
Nice!
There were still technical things that needed to be dealt with, but that's normal. You know, and they all knew that they had made this bond.
There was a lot of different personalities, but it just meshed together so well. We really felt like a family.
Everyone was different, but all together we made a championship team. It was pretty amazing. I've never felt that from a group of people before.
Everybody was able to contribute their own sort of special thing to this wonderful collaboration. And when you have all of these young dancers looking up to Michael, who thought they could dance and wanted to please him, and what a lot of people don't know is that he felt the same way. It was just wonderful to see that and feel it.
He was just so loving to us and so open. I felt like he would come in and the dancers would kind of like, we'd all get so excited.
dancers don't get treated so well in life, but when we dance for Michael, we get treated like we were stars. And you will feel so special when you dance next to him.
For us as dancers to be along beside him, you know, it was magic.
I'm so lucky as a fan to have been through this last process with him, because I got to witness so much.
I hope that I'll have another experience like this in my life, but I don't think I ever will.
Michael brought out the best in everybody. He brought you to your full potential.
He seemed so appreciative to have us, and God, I hope he knew how appreciative we were to have him, you know.
To dance on stage with Michael was the best experience I've ever had. We were living a dream, and we were living his dream, and we were doing it together. And the fact that we were able to do that with Mike, go on his adventure, as he liked to call it, you know, was an honor.